So this is like the second part of the Beethoven piano sonata number 10 video played by Barenboim. So what I like about the music, it's kind of cleansing the emotional auric fields of others and yourself as well, because it's like a higher quality that's coming in of life force. And it's very helpful to cleanse you after bad experiences you have had. For example, I'm constantly very tired, you know? I'm a very exhausted person, tired person, yeah. I'm I have years of subconscious pressure, you know, from environment, you know, of cars that was not fitting me at all. So I need to kind of this kind of service sometimes to cleanse myself. I was working in areas that was kind of, I had to protect my field all the time, you know. I was under pressure and, you know, had to figure out how to withdraw from human contact, and you know. So it's kind of like a therapeutic sound almost. Plus it's like a karmic request, you know. I need to do this because if a yogi leaves a karmic imprint, there's very strict rules about karma yoga. Then you should deal with your karma as well, as like you cannot escape it then. Let's say you go in there and leave behind a few piano sonatas or something, and later somebody decides to play them. You're pretty much like tied to kind of listening to this. It's just Beethoven is like also showing the karmic law, like how it works, you know. He went deaf, was deaf, and so it's very easy to understand he's going to come back to listen. Yeah. So it's like a standard. I think he was asked, you know, to show the standard school values of the ancient, you know. So I like how the Hindu karma things actually, you know, how they work, you know. Why one deed leads to some action. Because if you realize you're completely free to do something in any moment, and you choose a deed, like you choose a bad deed, like to hate, or you know, you believe you can start to act on hate or something, and you just destroy someone's window, you will have to like pay for the window, you know, or something. Or if you choose to do a good deed, like even though I'm hungry, I choose to be a good person to this and I help her or something, then it's gonna pay you back, yeah. So this is how it works, you know. And each moment you can choose what deed to do, you know. And the main aim of yoga in Hindu is the liberation of moksha, where you kind of realize that you don't have to do any deed. It's like the deeds that create these karmic worlds, right? Let's say you choose to play piano, then you're like in the piano world for a while because you choose to do these kind of deeds. And similarly, like the murder goes to prison and stuff like this. The model goes to stage and, you know, this teacher goes to the students and stuff like this, you know. And like who you are and what you do influences your future. So let's say this Barenboim guy has practiced for a while, he gets better and better. So what he gains like due to his karma is like this high level reputation of being a professional pianist, like one of the best, you know. So this like the result of his karmic deeds, you know. And there's many other things as well. And in my case, when I'm tired karmically, I need to find a space to kind of resolve this, you know, kind of to, not like to host, but to pull back, you know, and something, you know, figure out how to realize the rest. You know, how can I rest without being damaged, you know? Because there has been a lot of pressure towards myself. So it's like a constant practice how to realize this pressure and, you know, like through meditation, which is a very good thing and tool for myself. Through meditation I kind of start to rest really, you know? otherwise it's always like this old energy is attacking, you know? And so I'm like the spirit or ghost that goes through the eras also, you know? Thank you.